Dada Mahama na kwati o men yakonya kese eso na na se mo de atuja ene sei sei wo hwe Ghana economy no abosume pe enso economy na jija tete apansam ene wo mampen Dada Mahama na no a wo ye yi video ya chese woni nkofo onya nkita wo de na okire mu se na economy ya na mre bia be sinko MPP aban yetia konya so se ah enke economy de ye wo jina na so wo tia po wo jina brane no se ah na economy na ejina brani ninie ene 2 days pa COVID 19 won frama e wo so no ketua bi afa de economy no ajija as what da korebu anaji ye ade oxygen esi ni so ye no hwehnye ye afa de ohometwe twe twe economy ninie wose MPP fo ho propaganda no muja ya enke enyina beka bom amia ko COVID 19 enra wo she da je time pa social media Facebook radio so ni ade na cheso ni omafo enyankita wo de no de sa same se atuja.
This is one of the issues we have continuously talked about, that it is always necessary when you're building an economy to have enough buffers and create fiscal space so that when you are faced with a shock or adversity, you are easily able to overcome it. Unfortunately, this government has used a lot of propaganda. They said the economy has been the best that we've ever had since independence. Unfortunately, just 1 month of coronavirus and the economy is in ICU. If we didn't run to the IMF for the 1 billion rapid credit facility, it is possible that in the next 2 months, probably salaries could not have been paid. And so our economy is on ventilators and it needs thinking to rescue it from the ICU. And that is why we are continuing to review what government is doing. We're looking at what the figures are. I have my team working. We had worked with what was available to us before COVID, but we have to review that because next year, as the finance minister said, he says it's going to take 3 years for the economy to come back on its feet. And I remember that a leading member of this government told us our economy was so robust and we had such reserves that for 3 months, if anything happened to us, we will be able to survive. We've not been able to survive even 1 month. And so we will be able to recover our economy. And we are looking at, you know, what to put in place in order that we're able to recover. But there are things that the government can do in the first place. One of the main things you do when you're faced with adversity like this and shocks to the economy is to cut expenditure, frivolous expenditure. And that's why I said this is the time to look for the president to look at the number of his ministers and appointees. Definitely the public service is bloated, especially political appointees. And when you're asking people to sacrifice, you must show that you're sacrificing yourself. You can't have appointees running all over the place and drawing free fuel, and thousands of them, you know, I mean, just all over the place, 125 ministers, and you're asking the people to sacrifice. We're all going to sacrifice. It's going to take sacrifice to rebuild this economy. And the president and the government must show the first example that they're ready to sacrifice.